to this YouTube channel initiated by Gnan Manjari Modern School. As you know that in our previous video we have started grammar part, that is active and passive voice. It is very important topic, student, and some rule of active and passive I have given to you. Now it's time to go further, and still there are some rules remaining to be written. So first we'll deal with those rules. After that we'll go one by one for each and every tense. So up to those steps we have discussed in earlier video. So today the rule for active and passive is, in passive voice object is important while in active voice subject is important. So it is very important that we have to find out the place of object and subject in the sentence. As you know, student, that place of subject is at the beginning of the sentence, and object you will always find after verb. So subject at the starting point of the sentence. Where is our object? So object you will find just after main verb. So the object always follows verb. So just after main verb you will find the place of object. Now what was the rule we have discussed in previous video is, in active and passive voice, subject and object both change their position. It means subject becomes object and object becomes subject. So in passive voice, subject becomes the object of the passive sentence, and object becomes the subject of the subject. This is introduced with by. So you need to use by when you change any sentence into passive voice. So this is, these are the common rules for active and passive, student. Please note down this. After that, we will go for how this I will turn into me. That will be discussed later. But first, you have to note down this thing. Please, you have some time, note down this thing. Remember, student, passive voice important part is object, and in active voice important part is subject. Now as I told you, subject will be introduced with by. So what is that? Let's see. So when you have I in active voice, then I become by me in passive voice. When you have we, so it becomes by us. When you have they, it becomes by them. When you have she, it becomes by her. When you have he, it becomes by him. When you have you, it becomes by you. And it will becomes by it. See, I, we, he, she, it, you, they. So when you have this part in active voice, see, suppose I like this cake. So here my subject is I. This is our verb and this is our object. So as per rule, we have to change the place of subject and object. So this I will go there and this cake will come here. So we'll first write this cake. Now focus on verb student. Which tense is used here? So simple present tense is used. So this cake is liked by. Now just focus here. Here we have I. So when we have I in active voice, at that time this I will be turned into by me. So by me. This cake is liked by me. Second example. This is first. We sing a song. So this we is subject. Sing is our verb. A song is object. So, again this sentence is in simple present tense. So, a song, that is object, comes here. A song. We are talking about only one song. So, here a song is sung. Now, just look at here. Here we have we. So, when we have we have to turn that we with by us. So, a song is sung by us. So this way, the subject and object change their places when we change this sentence into passive voice. This is another rule, student. Please note down this thing with this example. You have some time. Another examples. See, now these are the example and rules of active and passive. Now we will start a simple present tense. You have passive voice in each and every tense. So when we just do this simple present tense in passive voice, you all are requested to watch that my first video of simple present tense, which we have posted here, and that will give you clear idea. So first see that video. After that, see this do this active and passive voice. So simple present tense. Please keep in your mind that we are talking about passive voice. So this is not active voice sentences. Simple present tense. The use of simple present tense, you all know that we use simple present tense to show or to suggest or to describe our daily habit, routine work, the principle of maths and science, and proverb and all. So here those rules are not going to be changed, student. The tense rule are same. We just need to change is the sentence pattern. So the passive and active voice is all the game of sentence pattern and rules. That's why I am insisting you to keep all the rules in your mind. So the rules, each and every rules I am writing here. So first is simple present tense. So first I will write the sentence pattern of active voice. Generally, we have our all the unit of English textbook in active voice. So we will try to convert those sentences into passive voice while we completed these all the tenses. So active voice sentence pattern of simple present tense is, we need subject, verb, and here we take s or es, plus v1 plus object, and at last the other voice. Now what to do in passive voice, student? We'll change this place of subject and object in passive voice. So passive voice, so what happened here, this object will come here, so here we'll write object. But this is which object? This one. After that, as we are talking about simple present tense, so we'll take M, is, or R with V3. So now what is this V3? So you have to take this V3 of this V1. Means here V1 is already given, suppose. So you have to remember that V3 of that verb. So after that, by will come. The by is compulsory. Now what happened? Object we have taken here. So after by, what will we do? We will take, that is subject. So subject and the other words. This is the sentence pattern of passive voice, and this is the sentence pattern of active voice in simple present tense. Now I will clear this idea by giving you examples. See, we eat those apples daily. So first identify the subject and object, and after that we will change according to this pattern. So here is our subject, this V. This is our verb. Those efforts are our object, and this is other words. Okay? See. So now what we have to do is, we have to change the place of subject and object. So this object will come here, and this V will go there. Okay? So those apples will come first. Those apples. Now look here, student. Apples here is plural form. We are talking about the more apples, so many apples. So what we will take from this, means object we have taken here. Here M is R. So we are talking about the plural form, so we will take R. So those apples are. Now what is our verb here? So our verb is eat. So now we want the V3 of this verb. So V3 of eat is eaten. Eat and eaten. After that, what come? Our by. And now subject. So subject is we. So that we becomes us. This way we change sentence of simple present tense in passive voice. Those apples are eaten by us daily. Student, please note down this sentence pattern and this sentence in your book. Sentence pattern is most an important part of passive voice. Please keep this in your mind, otherwise you will not able to do these sentences in your exam or test. So now you have some time to note down this thing in your book. Please note down. Okay, another example. My friend always helps me. Okay. So here subject is my friend. Helps is our verb. Me is object. So we will change this into passive now. So when me object is here, that me will come here. So that me will become I. Okay. I now the term we have to choose from this MSR. So I am. Now what is verb? Helps. But what about this always? That will not change its place. So I am always. Helps is verb. And we need V3 of help. So it is helped. I am always helped by my friend. This is the answer. Let me give you another example. They call me openly. Okay. So again here we have me. That me is me becomes I. With I we will take M. I am called by they become them openly. Or you can say openly. So these are the another examples of passive sentences. Please note down these examples, students. Some more examples.
in the school.
Now, teachers is our subject. Him is our object. Sorry, verb. Us is object. Here, homework is also object. So, this is object number one. This is object number two. This is our verb and this is our subject. So, as we have two objects here in this sentence, so our sentence will be two, means answers will be two. So, first we take us as an object. So, us becomes we, which we will always take are, we are given homework by the teacher daily in the school. And if we take homework as an object, so the answer will be they give me a gift on my every birthday. So first we will take me as an object. So I am given a gift by them on my every birthday. Now we will take a gift as an object. So a gift is given to me by him on my every birthday. So this can be two answer. Number three, again another sentence. Okay. her. And if we take my father as a verb object, so my father is presented a car, sorry, a big car. So this way we can change two object sentences like this. Please student, jot down these examples. Okay, so you must have had doubt in your mind that can we change each and every sentence into passive voice? Means each and every sentence from the textbook of our from the unit of our textbook. Can we change all the sentences into passive voice? No, we can't change all the sentences into passive voice. Only sentences with transitive verb can be changed into passive voice. See, this is another rule. Sentences with transitive verb can be changed into passive. Okay, so sentences with intransitive verb cannot be changed into passive. Let me give you an example. See, I jump from here. We go to Surat. They read a book. So how to identify that this verb from the sentence is transitive or intransitive? So first thing is, if you don't have object, then that verb is with intransitive verb. See, I jump from here. Now if you can't find even verb or object, so just ask the question using what to the verb. So to ask question using what to the verb. So our verb is here jump. This is our verb. So we will ask question to verb jump. I jump from here. Okay. So this sentence is in simple present tense. So our question will be, what do you jump? Do we get any answer here, student? What do you jump? No. We don't get any answer of this question. It means jump is here intransitive verb, and this intransitive verb sentence will not be changed into passive voice. Please remember this. Okay, we go to Surat. So if we ask question using what do you work? Does it make any sense? No. So of course here this sentence will not be changed at passive voice. They read a book. Let's ask question using what to eat. Our question is, what do they read? So do we get here any answer? What do they read? Of course we get, and our answer is a book. So this sentence can be changed into passive voice, and the answer is, a book is read by them. So we can say jump and go both are intransitive verb, and read is transitive verb. That's why we change that sentence into passive voice. So this way, intransitive verbs cannot be changed into passive voice, while only transitive verbs can be changed into passive. Please note down this useful information, students. So this is active and passive voice in simple present tense, in affirmative sentence. Still in simple present tense, negative, interrogative sentences are there. So now it's time to give you homework. I'm giving you some sentences and you have to turn that sentences into passive voice. So your homework is, we sleep 8 o'clock at night. So student, these 5 sentences you have to do in your homework. Whether just check that whether all the sentences can be changed into passive voice or not. If they can't change, then they must be in transitive verb. So please do this homework regularly. This is very important topic. You will see this topic in your 10th standard too. So we will meet again with another information of active and passive voice in next video. Please take care of yourself, student. Bye. Thank you.
Thank you.